Well, hello, and welcome back to Cooking Spaghetti with Sergi. Today, we will be cooking spaghetti. Apparently covered in crypt feces and who knows what else we crawled through while down there. Let's see, Chica's asleep. She's got stuff she needs to take care of. I need to start making plans for tomorrow, though. What do we got going on here? Legacy Park. Every time I see that fancy icon, it makes me think that something important is actually going on. Congratulations, Simon Brown. You are now a production manager. The set, crew, equipment, and assets are all under your purview as production manager, which means you're on the line when poorly supervised explosive stunts go boom. If you keep schmoozing celebrities after hours and help produce films on time and on budget, stardom will be yours. Upon learning that the business had denied his application for promotion, Simon Brown had lots to say. I thought he was already promoted. Griff Clown, you are now a thug. Congratulations. The best thugs are intimidating and muscular. Connor Mean Muggin. Connor Mean Muggin, you are now a grunt in the military. Try not to get shot. Carlos Lopez, you are now a city council member. And UB Sutton, your impressive performance has earned her a promotion to division manager. Somebody thinks you're going places, specifically the head of the division, sales, marketing, customer service, and manufacturing. All of them fall under the hefty chain of command that ends with you. Make $100 per hour. Frank and Beth, you've had a baby girl and named her Lillian. Congratulations. Coral Oldie was very forthright when asked about the money that she exchanged between her and the local gigolo Alexander Lundes. Hey, I required the services of a professional and received them. What the hell's the problem with that? I agree. Prostitution, I believe, is legal in this town. Who are we to judge what two consenting adults do? Especially if there's money involved. Let them do what they want. Sergi, you need to get your ass to bed. Sleep until 11:30. So this is about roughly the time I need to stay up every night. Provided I can keep Chica busy in the morning. So that she doesn't jump up on the bed around 7:30 and try to wake him up. Holy crap, that actually made me jump. You don't have to pay the property taxes. I will shoulder the awesome responsibility for you, mused the Baron, UB Sutton. All you do is blah, blah, blah. People can move in. Maybe Simon should have paid more attention at orientation because he isn't cutting it. He's been demoted to personal assistant already. Manny Sutton was observed feasting on a local sim recently. Nina Caliente, the diner. The dinner was best described by witnesses as being in a hypnotic trance or just plain out of her gourd. Nina is now recovering from the blood transfusion that she gave. Okay, Chica, you can go ahead and go pee here. Get that out of the way. Eat your food. Do some chewing. And then I want you gone today. I'm going to give her a full list of... There we go. I don't want her coming in and waking me up. I want a good full night's rest for a change. Chris Louder is still unroutable. I have no idea what the hell is going on with him. I know there's a way for me to manually move and reset Sims, but if he pops up again, I'll click on his picture. And we'll go see what's going on. The gnomes are poofing in and out. I shouldn't trust them around my cars. They could be sabotaging the brake lines, or worse. Go chew your stuff, Chica. Go chew in the rain. Hopefully you don't mind being a little bit wet. It's technically the same as a bath, I assure you. should take her just about all day and all of her energy to take care of. Consuela, don't care about you. Constance Lopez, a traffic cop. Silently judges. Impressive performance has earned her a promotion to traffic cop. Rebel Kane's wife is moving up quicker than he is, I think. Shona Yell is now a fortune guesser. Jasper, not primary, is now a desk jockey. Every case comes with a mountain of paperwork, and the sergeant will need some fresh coffee. Tend to the files and learn to wield a stapler as a desk jockey, and the lieutenant may see about getting you a position that has a bit more action. Grimmeth, apparently he's getting into politics. His impressive performance has earned him a promotion to yes man. Hopefully you're ready to nod your head in the affirmative because you've worked your way into the position of yes man. I expect him to be mayor someday. We never seriously damage our food supply. How would it benefit us to make those who provide us life hate us, commented Simon Brown, after having taken a succulent taste from local citizen Yubi Sutton? Even paid him. Revo Kane Dickbutt has just received a new peon in the form of Jasper, not primary. There's a lot going on. There's some bullies going on. Kurt Sutton and Dakota Dingbat are tracking their next victim in the personal fight on crime. Let them fight crime all they want. Keep sniffing out collectibles. It's still going to be a couple hours till Sergei has to get up. Digging holes, digging holes. Good lord, everyone's getting promoted again today. Gen A, calm. Behold, the terror of the pre-adolescents. Jolene Gilles-Carbo has arisen as a truly unruly brat, just what we need. A Vox's impressive performance has earned him a promotion to Spice Runner. The modern spice trade is here, and you are at the helm. A dash of paprika, organic sea salts, and just the right amount of cayenne can change any dish for the better. Or worse. It's all about the right spice at the right time in the life of a spice runner. So I guess he's moving up the culinary route. Wonder how many people he's cooking into his meals. Maybe he's going to open up a tea shop somewhere. Congratulations, Goopy now works at the police department. Goopy Gilles-Carbato. Blah, blah, blah. Dang crossbow. Blah, blah, blah. Don't attack the Slayer unless you know what you're doing. A motto to live by unless you happen to be named Van Valentine. Unfortunately for the poor wolf hunter who attempted to take down Hannah Hooker, it was the last thing he ever did. Really, the last thing he ever did? I know people can die. Whenever it words it like that, it leaves me curious. Maybe he's getting ready to die. This is just a prelude. Where is he going? Who do we have here? Brick Valentine and Van Valentine. Are they out hunting? I'm not entirely sure. Ah, dang it. There was Chris Lauder. Okay. Yep, I have no idea if they are going to go fight, or if they already have. What is this? Chica Frika gained a new trait. Yeah, we already know that she has the aggressive trait. You're a little bit behind, game. She earned that yesterday, unfortunately. There's been a few times where this thing is just slow, it seems like. I think because it has so much to process and catch up on. She wants to go home. Well, what do we have here? Sunstone. A gem. We have 2/3 fragments of our friend Fred. Saturday at 2:21. Hopefully the office can cope without Freddy Krueger for another hour, as he appears to be in no rush to get there. Lilith Pleasant is a street musician. Angela Pleasant got a new job. Van Valentine got his butt kicked and went to the hospital. More people are late. Sergei's finally getting up. A couple personal trainers, it looks like. Candy Hooker is now a roadie, which seems fitting. Oh my goodness. Jin A. Com and Grimmoth Reaper are now in a steady relationship. Grimmoth is marrying a sugar mama. Every politician has to be married. It appears that Angela Pleasant has outgrown her previous boss and been assigned a new one in the form of Nina Caliente. Sergey, did I tell you to do that? You're gonna eat some waffles, of course. You're gonna take a shower. You're gonna brush your teeth and feel good about yourself. And after that, we're gonna go do a little bit of low-level police work just to get those points. And then, we'll obtain a case. We'll pick up our case while we're doing our work. Meet the cops, pal around with the cops. Evidence room? More like fun room. There's all sorts of exciting things in here. Your cop buddies are all too eager to show off. Perform feats of logic. Flex perceptive prowess. You know what? We'll flex our perceptive prowess today. We're not going in just to have fun. I do need a partner, though. Chica, what are you doing? She's entertained. Just enough to keep the stress away. Oh, okay. At least they put a limit on how many collectibles your pet can find every day. 2 years ago, or however long ago it was, whenever I was going to originally record this, I found out pets are extremely versatile. I used to send them out basically hunting all day long, nonstop. Betty Lopez. It's the first warning sign from her, I think. Tastes like fridge. From cheap. That fridge is not cheap. It's like, that's my new one, right? I didn't somehow mysteriously lose stuff. Manny Sutton has been chatting everyone up about his new house. Martin Jones has moved out. I don't know who that is. He's moved into the family ranch at 2 Legacy Lane. And a recent inspection of the living conditions for the Henry family has shown serious concern. Missy has been contemplating a move in the future. Brush my teeth, keep my mood up a little bit. Chica's gonna need some more socialization. She is a needy dog, isn't she? Go ahead and... I guess I could have her manually? No, I can't. Okay. I'm gonna say that's kind of a loophole. Actually just, yeah, go here, and it'll page me with what to do. Those gnomes are popping in and out of existence again. Okay.
Redige, Misa.
Hey, Myra, she's chewing on it. You can't really put it up whenever the dog wants to chew on something. I don't like this maid. I have a feeling another day or so, and I'm going to be getting rid of her. There's got to be someone else better suited in this town to work for a private investigator. Let's see, you go there and you run around for a little bit. That'll make you happy. Who do we have here? Selena Stanford, some paparazzi. Why is there graduation music playing? Now, am I getting job performance from this? I am. Or job experience. It's not the type of experience I want. I'm sure it's making my sim really unhappy. Yeah, let's get the hell out of here. Yay, we earned $11. Celia. If you weren't such a creeper, I would... ask for your number, but never get a paparazzi's number. Chris Lauder, why are you unroutable? Where are you? Oh, you're underneath a house. I think. The case of Gnome Footsie. It's often said that you shouldn't keep a garden gnome if you have soft-toed shoes. The things are so kickable. Unfortunately, Alianiratina wants me to track down who is kicking a gnome. Alianira's gnome, that is. I should ask her, who would do such a thing? Okay, I guess we can go do that. Chris, you're fucked. I don't know what's going on with you. Are you trapped in the house? Shut up. I don't want to hear it. Yep. Go get your interview on. Some money was given out. My maid's gone. Without outright admitting his involvement in any illegal activities around town, Bruce Metzen has been spreading the word that he does not like how local cat Jason Voorhees is composing himself. The cops have their eye on you, Jason. Try to rob me, Willie. Well, I'll teach him a thing or two. Grumbled silently judges after catching the local cat trying to break into her home. After a quick takedown, Jason Voorhees found himself on the floor with a mighty bruised ego. Silently, you should arrest him. And what is she doing way out here? This is like Creepy Stalker Alley or something. Your pathing is fine. She's right there. Grimmoth Reaper and Jeff Major have decided that living together under the same roof is no longer feasible. Oh, she went inside. Not only did she go inside, she teleported away. Son of a gun. I hate fairies and their magical teleporting abilities. I'm no longer fine with having that lout in my house, Jeff was heard saying, so Grimmoth is going to move out. But he moved in with Jin, which I'm pretty sure everyone figured was inevitable. Babies was the only word silently judges Dick Butt and Revo Kane could say when they were beaming. Apparently there's a new bundle of joy in their future. I could have sworn that they were already going to have babies. Maybe I'm thinking of someone else. It's hard for me to keep up with all of the Sims that I've added and everything that they're all up to. Okay, Alianira. Oh my goodness, you are a long ways away. Wait, not that long. Okay, finally caught up to her. She's teleporting around. Why don't you tell me more about your gnome? What's he up to? How many other gnomes does he comport with? What time of night does he disappear and show back up? Let's see, Tina's fairly convinced that the next door neighbor, Killigan, is guilty of the gnome kicking. I should rummage through Killigan's garbage to see if I can find any evidence of wrongdoing. Maybe then she can bring her gnome out of hiding. Okay. Case of the gnome footsie. Again, I should probably do this late at night, but I don't really care if anyone sees me rummaging through garbage. I like these log cabin houses. They need to plant some trees, though. Make this a little bit more wildernessy. You've got the suburbs here, and Aunt Jemima's estate over here. Whoops, after failing to pay his child support, apparently someone decided to call in the coppers. Manny Sutton has landed himself a nice cot at the city jail while the authorities sort out the complaint. Enjoy your time in jail, Manny. You definitely deserve it. I wonder how many days he'll be locked up for it. How many days of his life are going to go to waste? Chris, I don't like you. If I knew how to deal with you... Hang on. Where is he? Where is he? We're going to try something here. Okay. NRAAS, Master Progression. Status... I don't understand. Let's see, Lauder. How do I move him? Advanced, basic, household, make active, advanced, force kill, reset sim. Yes, reset him. Okay. So that's how you do it. That wasn't too hard to figure out. However, yeah, make sure nobody's looking. Somebody's home! Crap, it's my car though. I am the best investigator of all time. See anything interesting in there? Yeah. Anything good? Even if it's not evidence, we can still take it back to the house. Thankfully, no one in these cars cares. Why would Killigan own shoes with toes so mangled, presumably from kicking a gnome, that they needed to be thrown away? Very peculiar. I should speak to Killigan about these shoes. Okay, let's go hunt him down. Had they known you were going to go digging... Wait, had they known you'd go digging through their trash, I bet they never would have tossed out this morsel of information. Could potentially be used to blackmail its owner if he didn't value their friendship. Well, I don't value his friendship. I don't mind that he's kicking gnomes, but I've been paid to do a job, and I'm a professional. In cases like this, I've at least got to confront him about it. Even if I go back to Tina and say, yeah, I don't think it's him doing it. Sandra Lothario, Killigan, Abel, what are you doing? Josh Hackett, Dennis the Menace, he's grown up. He's now a teenager, a little shit. Yeah, so why don't you tell me about these shoes, Killigan? Killigan confessed to kicking the gnome and to having pronounced anger management issues. Killigan agreed to stop kicking the gnome and to seek counseling. I should tell Tina the good news. You want to buy a trampoline. Why would you want a trampoline? Got some decent job experience. We're not going to hang around town here. Whoa. There's a gnome right there. He was watching the entire time. I doubt that's her gnome. Ha 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 ha. Never trust a gnome. Telling you, this town might actually be ran by the gnomes. We're gonna find the gnome underground at some point. I just wanna whoop some evil scum. Bring it on, Carlos Lopez and Morgan God have been tracking down people to beat up. Don't fairies melt in the rain? Maybe not. So, Tina was relieved to hear about an end to the gnome abuse. The poor battered gnome will soon be comfortable in the sun once again. As for me, I've earned my pay. Flange Bob is hungry again. We need to decide what we're going to do with the rest of the day, though. I suggest... I really wish I could find that bar. Llama Sports Bar. The Bowling Alley. Rock and Stomp again. I don't know what that little pie piece means. The Cement Shoe Factory. Why do they have a virology department? It's kind of unnerving. Disco Tetris. Dock Station. Port Refuse. Stop and Charge. Egyptian Lounge, Crypto Night. I just wish I knew where the Mafia was working out of. Wait. Restaurant. The Little Corsasian Bistro. Get Family Job. How do I do a steak out there? It figures that they would stage out of there. Maybe I can't do a steak out here. Let's see, let's go to the restaurant and... we'll just get drinks. With others, we'll call Durandal there. We can go share some drinks and then I'll do a steak out or two. Good day, Tina. I hope your gnome's safe. For now. I don't want the gnomes to play their cards too early. What? What? Manny Sutton and Daniel Pleasant. Running through like the Flash. Are they chasing each other or working together? Hey, Durandal's got a nice dress too. Another vampire goes running by? I think that's who that is. Flange Bob McVaginata. The vampires are just... Is he a vampire? I can't tell. Too many people. Get drinks. We're gonna come out completely sloshed. The bartender needs a test subject to try a new fruit cocktail he's working on. It'll be on the house, of course. Are you game? Sure. The bartender mixes a myriad of fruits in a flurry and hands you a misting glass. It's one of the best drinks you've ever had. You feel amazing. That paparazzi can't keep up with the vampire. She's no Flash. We have an adrenaline rush. This will keep the sim pumped and running around everywhere for some time to come. And for some time to come, it means 3 hours. We're not gonna watch TV. Where is she at? Silently judges Dick Butt. Everybody's running through here. Let's do a stakeout here. Oh, wait. Yeah, quit the stakeout. Let's have a talk with her. Or go... We could go to another venue. See, a single sim trailer? That's a venue. Arcade suite bowling alley. Bot competition arena. Flying V's coffee house. Dive bar rock and stomp. I guess this would be a good way... find the mafia bar, maybe. I don't know. Could go to the cemetery, even though I don't really want to go back to the cemetery after seeing what she did to that dog. Hangout, Lucky Casino, Hidden Tomb. Wow. Junkyard, Port Refuse. We could go hang out at the laundromat. Live show venue, Nectary, Nectar Barn. There's a lot of locations in this town. Serenity Retreat, Poolside Club. It's gonna be late soon. I wonder how late these places are open. Supernatural Hangout, Wolfbane Tavern. I don't really want to go there. We're not a supernatural. And I wouldn't feel safe taking a date to one of those places. What if we get bit or something? We'll go to the Lucky Casino. Who is this? Chris Lauder. Are you glad to be free from under that house, finally? Oh, cool. She can actually take the car with me. Become a partner at several businesses. Might be able to arrange that. Such a shame. Apparently, Butter Hooker and Griff Clown have broken up. Aww. I'm sorry to hear that, Griff. Hey, it's Sabrina, I think. Serafina. I'm gonna just call her Sabrina. Okay. Let's see. Your sim has just entered a group. There are different social interactions available when your sim groups with other sims. No. First up, let's compliment appearance. And... ask if contagious. What, is she sick? Do you have any diseases I should know about before this goes any further? In the chat. Let's see. We'll buy a round of drinks. She's just an acquaintance for now. Play Smack a Gnome. Said this was a casino, right? Where's like the one-armed bandits? Grab a prize. Where's the poker tables? The roulette. Got a room up there I could rent? Somebody could rent anyways. What is a kid doing here? Kimberly Thornton. Come on, Durandal. Let's have a round of drinks before the night's over with. What do we got here? Attractive company. My sim actually likes the music here. It's kind of a surprise. Not a good sign when she sets with the space between us. As long as I don't have to pay for it, you can drop as many drinks as you want. I think I'm actually going to end the video here. Whenever we come back, we will continue this little date and then probably head home. What we'll do tomorrow, I don't quite know yet. Party drinks. Sounds delicious.